Hi, this is Amy from Pressure Cook Recipes. Welcome to Cooking Together with Amy and Jackie. Hope you're having a lovely week. First, we want to thank all of you who joined the Star Wars giveaway in our last episode. So now's the moment you've been waiting for. We're drawing the winner for the adorable BB-8 Instant Pot. So let's see who's the winner. Lisa Merrill Price. Congratulations to Lisa Merrill Price. So you can contact us on our website at pressurecookrecipes.com and we'll arrange your prize and we'll mail it to you. So today we're excited to share a new recipe with you. If you enjoyed our jambalaya or gumbo recipes, you gotta try this Instant Pot Red Beans and Rice. In this episode, we'll take you through step by step on how to cook this easy red beans and rice in your Instant Pot or pressure cooker. Make sure you subscribe so you won't miss any future recipes. So, what is red beans and rice? Red beans and rice is a classic Louisiana Creole dish that's loved by many people. So every red beans and rice recipe are a little different, and that's what makes it special. They're mostly made of red kidney beans, the Cajun Holy Trinity, which is the bell pepper, onion, and celery. And there's also smoked ham hock and gooey sausage and spices. By the way, if you're looking for another recipe that uses red kidney beans, you gotta try our fans' favorite umami chili. Using the Instant Pot makes this easy meal even easier because you don't have to wash the pot and wait for it to simmer for hours on the stove. You'll love how the tender pork with juicy sausages and creamy beans with just a bit of heat. It's really comforting to eat, and it goes so well with rice. We just couldn't stop eating. So let's check out the ingredients. Soy sauce is definitely not a traditional ingredient in a classic red beans and rice. But wait, we love using it for that extra oomph of umami complexity. So try it and see what you think. There are two methods to soak your beans. The overnight soak and quick soak. But for better results, we recommend soaking the beans overnight. If you're using canned beans, you don't have to soak them. Just strain and rinse them under cold water before cooking. Hey, have you thought about how food is so much more than things that keep us alive? Not only are there cultural and historical value, but food can also carry powerful memories and emotions that stay with us. So yes, your loved ones will remember the food you've made for them. It might have happened to you before. When you tasted a certain dish, it brings back the warm, fuzzy feelings and happy memories. In such a unique time like this, let us use what we have on hand to create more delicious memories filled with smells and love. I'd love to know, does your family have any food traditions? Let us know in the comments. When the indicator says hot, add olive oil or vegetable oil and slice sausages in the Instant Pot. Then sauté for 4 minutes. The quality and taste of your andouille sausage and smoked pork hock will affect the flavors they impart to the final dish. So try to use ones that are high quality. Add in diced onions, green bell peppers, and celery. Then sauté for 3 minutes. Add in minced garlic, dried thyme and oregano,
bay leaves, smoked paprika, and cayenne pepper. Then saute for another minute. Some of you might be wondering how spicy is this red beans and rice recipe. The spiciness will mostly come from your sausages and cayenne pepper. So choose accordingly and adjust how much cayenne pepper to use. Add in unsalted chicken stock. Then deglaze by scrubbing all that flavorful brown bits off the bottom. Add in regular soy sauce. Then give it a quick mix. So now push all the ingredients to one side. Then add in all the red kidney beans. Then thoroughly mix them together. Pour in all the remaining unsalted chicken stock. So make sure all the beans are completely submerged in the stock. Finally, add in the smoked pork hock. Make sure to push it down so it's mostly submerged in the stock. Then set it to pressure cook at high pressure for 20 minutes, followed by 20 minutes natural release. When the Instant Pot is natural releasing, it's a good time to start cooking the rice. So after 20 minutes, release the remaining pressure by turning the venting knob to the venting position. Oh, it smells so good. So yeah, it'll look a bit watery at first, but that's normal. You can reduce and thicken the gravy by using the saute more function to let it simmer. Fine and discard the bay leaves. Then shred the pork and add them back in the Instant Pot. Stir occasionally, then let it simmer until your desired consistency. As always, don't forget to taste and adjust the seasoning. Enjoy this tasty Instant Pot red beans and rice.
Thank you so much for watching this episode of Cooking Together with Amy and Jackie. If you enjoyed it, please smash the like button. We'll be releasing more Instant Pot recipe videos every week. Make sure you subscribe and ring the bell icon. Also, follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Happy cooking and keep smiling. See you next week.